Hi, I'm Maggie Eber from HiveMQ. In this short video, I'd like to tell you everything you have to know about HiveMQ 4.4. HiveMQ 4.4 is the result of our customers' feedback and can quickly be divided into three main themes. First of all, easier automation of operations. We did a lot here to enable HiveMQ operators to automate the operation of HiveMQ. Then we added finer-grained observability with a lot of new control center views, new MQTT topics, and a feature called client event history. And last but not least, easier integration into other systems. As always, check out the release blog post for more details, but here's the summary. So let's dive deeper into the highlights of this release. With HiveMQ 4.4, we proudly introduce our new REST API, which allows HiveMQ operators to automate actions they would normally perform manually. For example, the REST API can be used to interact with HiveMQ programmatically, to start a trace recording, or to initiate a backup process. Included in this release is the REST API for the backup and restore functionality, the client's overview and details, and the trace recordings. For your convenience, we offer a code generator for easily creating API clients and models. HiveMQ deployments can handle millions of clients with massive amount of data. This leads to a lot of action on the cluster and the need to observe the cluster, for example, using the trace recordings or the event log. The newly introduced client event history adds finer-grained per-client observability into the HiveMQ control center and provides a 7-day historical view of client events. This makes it easy for you to troubleshoot a single client and helps you to diagnose problems, even at a later time. The integration in our extension SDK allows you to trigger actions based on the events or export the historical data to analyze in a third-party tool. Last month, we announced the early access preview of our HiveMQ Kubernetes Operator that significantly simplifies the deployment and operation of HiveMQ clusters on any Kubernetes-based platform. Additionally, the operator provides HiveMQ extension lifecycle management, automated monitoring with Prometheus, and is managed with predefined Helm charts that also get you started quickly. In any IoT deployment, there are two main reasons if MQTT messages do not arrive at a subscribing client. Either the MQTT message expired before it could get delivered, or the MQTT broker dropped the message. This can happen when MQTT clients are too slow in consuming messages, or if they are not connected for a long period of time. In both cases, you certainly want to know which messages were not delivered and for what reason. HiveMQ 4.4 now introduces additional topics to get this kind of information that you can use for analysis, reporting, and further inspection. The expired topic offers you an easy way to be informed about all messages that were expired on HiveMQ. With additional data like the client or shared subscription the message was expired for. The drop topic, conversely, informs you about all dropped messages, including the dropped reason code and the client it was dropped for. The messages are republished using standard MQTT mechanisms and can be integrated with your MQTT security mechanisms, so it is 100% compatible with the MQTT 5 specification. Especially in the industry sector, HiveMQ customers are using multiple deployments in different and restricted environments, like factories. Sharing important IoT data between these environments or stream important data to the central data center is one main concern here. So we are thrilled to introduce our Enterprise Bridge extension, a scalable and secure solution to bridge between a HiveMQ cluster and any other MQTT broker. It includes bidirectional communication using flexible topic mappings, similar to the concept you're known to from our HiveMQ Enterprise extension for Kafka. Speaking of the Kafka extension, the HiveMQ Enterprise extension for Kafka is the industry's most scalable and best way for bidirectional integration of MQTT messages with Kafka. The newly introduced customization API allows for sophisticated and customized handling of message transformation that basically allows you to programmatically define how you want to transform, for example, an MQTT message into a Kafka record. For a finer grind observability of your HiveMQ deployment and IoT system, we added additional views to the HiveMQ Control Center. See all available shared subscriptions and the clients that are part of a share group at a glance in the new shared subscription overview and detail view. Or use the new message queue size column in the client overview to sort the clients based on the size of their queue. This is a convenient way to identify the clients that used up their queue limit and for which HiveMQ already drops or starts to drop messages soon. With HiveMQ 4.4, we now also display session attributes in the client detail view, so you can check whether the session attributes are set correctly. One of the unique features of HiveMQ is its flexibility to integrate with other systems. With the current release, HiveMQ's extension framework is extended to include some new APIs. For example, to get all retained messages, the timestamp of the arrival of a published packet, or to set the queue size of an individual client. HiveMQ customers require a tool that helps them to get all information about the clients that have a session with a HiveMQ broker. This prompted us to extend the functionality of the MQTT CLI to add export functionality for all clients connected to a HiveMQ broker. The brand new client export functionality of the MQTT CLI gives you all the details about the connected clients that you are already used to from the control center. The data from all clients is exported to a CSV file, so you can import it, for example, into Microsoft Excel or similar to sort, filter, and search for specific characteristics. To sum this version of HiveMQ up, we now release HiveMQ with all enterprise extensions, the Kubernetes operator, and the MQTT CLI as a bundle, so you have everything available with just one download. And as usual, there are always more features. Find more information about this release in our HiveMQ 4.4 release blog post and check out the new version. Let me know what you think about the new features. Feel free to leave a comment or reach out to me.